Hello everyone, my name is Ralord from the Illuvium community. I want to make a tutorial on how to buy the Illuvium token and stake it in the protocol. All links and all the contract addresses of the different tokens we talk about are going to be down in the description. There will be some cuts in the video, but Jeff has gratefully accepted to edit the video for us. So thank you, Jeff. This is my first time making a video, so bear with me. I will try to keep it concise while showing you a full flow of the process and some tips and tricks along the way. I will answer some common questions we get in the Discord server. First of all, the main misconception we see from newcomers is that owning the token is necessary to play the game. This is false. You can play the game using Ethereum or SILV, which you can obtain by staking the ILV token and choosing SILV as the reward. The in-game marketplace is going to be only with Ethereum. The fees to play the game, like traveling to a region or curing a shard, for example, can be paid with SILV or Ethereum. To begin, you will need a Web3 wallet. We recommend MetaMask as it is the most convenient and user-friendly. On top of that, the moderator team will be able to assist you more easily if you have any problem during the process, as we are familiar with that wallet. So I'm gonna install MetaMask and you can follow along the way. This is gonna be a demo wallet, just for the sake of installing it and showing you some tips and tricks. There we go. So we can get started. We're gonna create a new wallet. And we're going to say no thanks to all of that. Now you will create a strong password. If anyone gets access to that password and your computer, they can transact your cryptocurrencies. So make sure to use a strong password. You should now read and agree to the term of use. You can watch their video and read what they say about your recovery phrase, which is your seed phrase. Your seed phrase is a string of 12 words that are used to recover your wallet in case you lose your computer, for example. Or if you use a hardware wallet, you will need your seed phrase to recover that wallet if you ever lose your physical device. It is important to keep it safe, because anyone that has access to that seed phrase will be able to recover your wallet and withdraw all the cryptocurrencies on it without the password. So keep it safe. Don't keep it digitally. No screenshot. Don't take notes of it either on your computer. Only write it down on a piece of paper. And you can also buy steel container, which are called crypto steel, that are gonna protect your seed from fire. So I'm gonna reveal that seed. I'm only gonna use that wallet as a demo. I'm gonna remove it after. So for the sake of the tutorial, I'm gonna copy those words because they will ask to confirm. Now, you need to put them in the correct order. So note them in the correct order as well. I'm gonna do that now. Congratulations. So now we are done. We can now use that wallet. The first tip is to click on the account and it's going to copy your Ethereum address. When sending any ERC20 token to that wallet, you can use your Ethereum address and it's going to send it to that wallet. The first thing you will want to do is go to the settings. In advanced settings, you're gonna activate advanced gas control. It will help us later down the road. You can also rename your wallet if you want by clicking here on account details and renaming the wallet. So let's call it MetaMask. There we go. I will now show you how to add tokens. You need to add tokens manually on those wallets. So for example, if we want to add the ILV token, you can go to CoinGecko And the contract address is going to show right here. So you can copy it, go to MetaMask, add token. You're going to do custom token, paste that address, and it's going to recognize that it's the ILV token with the good amount of decimals. So you're going to do next and add tokens. So now when we transact and swap Ethereum for ILV, you're going to see your ILV tokens in your wallet. Another important point I want to touch on is for the people coming from Binance or other centralized exchange. When you want to withdraw your Ethereum to your MetaMask wallet, you want to choose the good chain. So I copy their address, I'm going to paste it there. I'm going to select the Ethereum network, ERC20. If you don't do that, you might end up losing your Ethereum and it's going to be hard to recover. So make sure to pick the good network. The reason why we want to send Ethereum first to the MetaMask wallet is because any transaction on the Ethereum network is going to cost gas fees. You can use the website gasnow.org to figure out what G-way you're supposed to use to make sure your transaction goes through in a timely manner. So for example, if you would put 25 during a transaction, it would take around more than 10 minutes. Okay, so now we will talk about buying the Illuvium token and staking it. You can go on the Illuvium staking website and click on core pools, where you will see both available pool. To stake in the Illuvium pool, you only need the Illuvium token. To stake in the Sushi LP pool, you first need to provide liquidity on SushiSwap to the pair Ethereum and Illuvium. I'm going to do that in this tutorial since this is the most complex part. I'm still going to go through the process of buying ILV at the same time. You can then click stake, choose flexible, which means your token are not locked and you can withdraw at any time. Or you can lock your tokens for any duration up to 52 weeks for double the rewards you would get if you didn't lock. It is important to note that when you stake your token and you were already staked, you will be forced to claim your pending rewards. If you want to add to your stake, keep that in mind because that will cost gas. If you want to withdraw your stake, it will force you to claim your pending rewards as well. To buy the token, you can click on the link in the description, which will lead you to the SushiSwap decentralized exchange under the swap page and with the good currencies already there, so Ethereum and Illuvium. You can then connect your wallet. We will pick MetaMask as it is the one we set up previously. You will then be prompted to select which account you want to use with that exchange. I'm going to put Ledger as I'm using my hardware wallet. I'm going to click connect. Now, SushiSwap has access to currencies we have in our MetaMask wallet. The first time you use it, you will need to approve the Ethereum cryptocurrency to be spent by SushiSwap. So you can accept that transaction. I'm now going to buy Ethereum worth of Illuvium token, which is about half of my balance, because I want to be providing liquidity after that to then stake into the SushiSwap LP pool. This is where the GasNow website takes action. So when you want to do a transaction, you need to select speed at which the transaction will occur. So for example, fast right now is 22. So I'm going to pick 22 when doing my transaction. I'm going to do swap and confirm my swap. There we go. So we said 21 should be good. I'm gonna check. 23 it is. So I'm gonna do 23. And this is where the advanced gas fees are shown. So the settings we set up previously. So this is good. I'm gonna confirm. And you can ignore that Windows security thing because I'm using a Ledger wallet. I'm going to accept the transaction on my device. It is now sent to the blockchain. So to check, you can then click here on View on Explorer or on MetaMask wallet. You can always check by clicking that arrow and view the transaction on Etherscan. So now it is pending, and now it is successful. So I now have Illuvium token in my wallet, as we can see right here. Once you have acquired your ILV tokens, you can then proceed to the Illuvium staking website and stake those if you want to stake into the Illuvium pool. So right there, it would prompt you to approve the token like you did on SushiSwap to be spent by the Illuvium website. So you would do that and approve the transaction. Since we want to stake in the second pool, we need to first provide liquidity. To do that, you can click on the second link in the description, which will lead you to the liquidity tab of the SushiSwap exchange with the input of Ethereum and Illuvium. So I will click maximum on my Illuvium balance to be spent. It will then match with the exact amount in dollar value in Ethereum. You're gonna then need to approve the Illuvium tokens since you didn't do it yet. Since I already did it, it's not gonna prompt me. So I'm gonna add the liquidity. We can now check on gas now again to make sure we use a fast enough gas. So 21 is good. I'm gonna confirm. This is normal. It will show you a huge amount of Ethereum as fees for the transaction because it will add that Ethereum to the pool. So this is totally normal. Don't panic. You can confirm. And I'm gonna accept the transaction on my ledger. So you can see the add liquidity. You can then do the same process and check the transaction. It is now confirmed. We now have SushiSwap LP token in our wallet. You can add the contract address, which is down in the description, to add the SLP token. Now I received SLP tokens. You can then take those to the Illuvium staking website and stake them. We're gonna do that now. I'm gonna stake them flexible. Here it says, before you can stake, you first have to claim your existing rewards. Like I said previously, so I'm gonna pick ILV, and since I'm staked in the SLP pool already, it's gonna prompt two transactions, one to claim the reward for the SLP pool and one to claim the reward of my compounding rewards, which are staked in the Illuvium pool. It is normal to pay two transactions when you stake SLP, and it will always be the case. We recommend claiming only the SLP reward as it claims both pool automatically anyway. So to spend the minimum amount of gas, you should only claim your rewards of the Sushi LP pool. I'm now gonna stake. I'm gonna check the gas now. Fast is now 28. I'm gonna adjust that to 28. And I'm gonna confirm adding my stake. So those are the transactions to claim my rewards, which needs to happen before. There we go. So we have the confirmation that our deposit was successful and we claimed the rewards that were pending. You can now proceed to your dashboard, and there you will be able to see the amount of Illuvium you have staked or the amount of Sushi LP you have staked. To withdraw your stake, if you are in the flexible pool, you can go to vesting and you can filter by deposit, and there you're gonna see all the deposits you made. So you are able to withdraw if you are not locked. If during the process you have a failed transaction with an out of gas error, you can then retry the transaction by setting a manual limit of
500,000.
This will allow the transaction to go through successfully and will use the gas that it needs to, so you won't pay the full amount. This is a common fix and something that we encounter in the Discord on a daily basis. I'll now go over the best practice on how to claim your pending ILV rewards depending on which pool you are staked in. If you are staked In the ILV pool, you can go ahead and claim your rewards and choosing any speed you want for the transaction. If you want to save on gas fee, you can even set it as low as 10, for example, and wait for it to go through during the week if the gas goes that low. You can see the difference it makes on the cost of the transaction. Keep in mind that by doing so, you won't be able to do any other transactions with your MetaMask account while waiting for that transaction to go through. If you are staked in the SLP pool, this next part is very important. The best practice is to claim your ILV rewards from the SLP pool only. By doing so, it will automatically claim the ILV pool rewards as well anyway. If you want to set a slow speed transaction for your claim with the SLP pool, you can do so by making sure that both pool transactions on your MetaMask have the exact same GWAY. So for example, we could set 15 on that one, confirm, and set 15 on the second one and confirm. You cannot only claim the SLP pool only, since it is impossible and the transaction will fail if you reject one of the two transactions. For more detailed explanation on why it is built that way, you can head over to the Discord server and in the staking channel, search for Aaron pinned message. The TLDR is that it is the cheapest way to proceed for the user in terms of amount of transaction and gas fees to get the compounding effect. To answer a frequent question we get on the Discord concerning the NFTs available under the Illuvium collection on OpenSea, those are collectible that can be used in-game except for those Ramfire Genesis promo. So these three are not usable. Those are promotional NFTs, but all the other ones, so the emotes, the badge, and the skin for Mozart, are usable in-game, but you will be required to burn your NFT, so it will be destroyed and you won't be able to trade it once you claim it in-game. To finish this tutorial, I'd like to add that staking in the SLP pool by providing liquidity to the trading pair is not risk-free. You should search impermanent loss on Google and understand it before taking any action. Staking in the SLP pool is also more costly on transaction fees, as you could see. You should wait to have enough rewards pooled before claiming them to not spend Ethereum on transaction fees for nothing. As always, I strongly recommend to everyone to do your own research and that nothing in this tutorial is financial advice. If you have any questions, you can DM me in the Discord server or ask one of the moderators and they will be able to assist you. Thank you for listening and I hope I could help you. A huge thank again to Jeff for editing the video. Happy staking, everyone.